the war, and God has brought us safely. It's not by how strong we are, but it's by God that has been mighty and has been glorious. Just begin to think deep. Thank Him for the food, thank Him for the shelter, thank Him that you are not under the bridge, thank Him for your children that He has kept. Just begin to bless His holy name. Thank God that we are not in a mortuary, but we are in a sanctuary again to give Him thanks, again to give Him glory, because only Him deserves it. Also use this medium to ask for mercy. Lord, if there's anywhere I've come short of your glory, knowing and unknowingly, in thoughts and in words, in what I have done, in what I have failed to do, Lord Jesus, have mercy upon me, because the Bible says that it's not of he that willeth or he that runneth, but of the Lord that showeth mercy. Lord, show forth your mercy in my life. Thank you, Jesus. Just bless you. You were highly lifted up.
Thank you.
Jesus cannot do. That situation, that sickness, that problem, just lay it out to Jesus this morning. And he's able to do. Let's have a heart of worship this morning. Let's say, Jesus, I worship you because you are true. You are God Almighty.
Glorious God, Jesús. You are there to take me to the top. Lord, now you be my everything. Now you. Thank you. here that has been battling with a certain health issue, unusually prolonged. God said he has sent his healing wind to blow it off you from today. And good health is being restored unto you. Amen. Number two says, there's someone there who celebrated something some time ago. But afterwards, that object of celebration was being attacked. And you don't know what else to do after doing all you thought needed to be done. God said I should tell you that the breakthrough you need to normalize the situation is being divinely released to you now. And by this time tomorrow, you will look back and smile again. Number two says, God said I should tell someone here this, I will make the process a walkover for you because you kept my way through the test. Amen. Number four says, God said I should tell someone here this, and you will know you are the one. Tell that sibling of yours that I am, capital letter, still in control. And I will see to the full blossoming of it. So no fears. Number five says, God said I should tell someone here this, because you have resumed that which I taught you to do, to be doing, which demand and pressure around you, made you to stop doing. I have resumed my special favor in your life too. Amen. Let me take that again, please. God said I should tell someone here this, because you have resumed that which I taught you to be doing, which the demand and pressures around you made you to stop doing, I have resumed my special favor in your life too. Number six says, there's someone here that was relegated to the background of affairs in your place of operation before now. But God said I should tell you that as he has started changing that trend, placing you in the forefront, so shall it be from now on, because you will not be relegated again. Number seven says, God said I should tell someone near this, the one you saw in your vision of the night is the one I called you to work with, to keep working for you. Don't let anything get you off except I tell you otherwise, in which case I will make so clear to you. Amen. Number eight and the last one says, God said I should tell someone here this, the satanic food you were given to eat while you slept, which is bringing discomfort on your inside, is being nullified by the power at work in this service, and the discomfort will disappear naturally. Amen. And the Lord will watch over his word to performance in our lives in Jesus' name.